वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर अस.
रोल ऑफ योगा इन स्ट्रेस मैनेजमेंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक. सो मैं अब डॉक्टर संध्या चौधरी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री एनआरईसी कॉलेज को बुलाना चाहूंगी डॉक्टर प्रिया वर्मा जी के वेलकम के लिए. डॉक्टर संध्या चौधरी, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन एंड थैंक यू डॉक्टर संध्या एंड आई एम ऑल्सो थैंकफुल टू द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स फॉर गिविंग मी एन अपॉर्चुनिटी to present my views on this topic. So as we all of us know, we are running short of time, so I'll be a little bit faster. So now starting with the topic, my topic, the role of yoga in stress management. As we all know, the modern world is facing pandemic COVID-19, which is a never foreseen situation, and we all are bearing with this. As a result, we are going through stress. Now, what is stress? Stress is defined as the inability to cope with a real or imagined threat to one's mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual well-being, which results in a series of physiological response and adaptation. And in this lockdown period, unfortunately, the stress has become a universal problem and has detrimental effect on mental, physical, and psychological health of all the individuals. All of us are familiar with the word yoga. Yoga is derived from the Sanskrit word yuj, that is, meaning is unite, that is the union of body, mind, and spirit. Yogic lifestyle, yogic diet, yogic attitude, and various yogic practices help humans to strengthen themselves and develop positive health, thus enabling them to withstand stress better. This yogic health insurance is achieved by normalizing the perception of stress, optimizing the reaction to it, and by releasing the pent-up stress effectively through various yogic practices. Yoga practice includes the use of physical postures, that is asana, controlled breathing, means pranayama, and meditation. Now, let us know the relevance of yoga in medical profession. Yoga helps us or reorient the functional hierarchy of the entire nervous system. Yoga also has shown some scientific evidence which indicates that yoga is promoting preventive and curative potential, that is, safe and it's a non-pharmacological therapy and also an effective lifestyle adjunct to reduce the drug dosage and also improve the quality of life of patients. Yoga also helps us in dealing with the psychosomatic and stress-related disorders such as diabetes mellitus, hypertension, bronchial asthma, irritable bowel syndrome, epilepsy, backache, and functional disorders. Yoga reduces, eliminates drug dosage and dependence in diabetes mellitus, hypertension, epilepsy, anxiety, bronchial asthma, constipation, insomnia, arthritis, sinusitis, and dermatological disorders. Now let us know the physiology of yoga. Various functions of our body are controlled by autonomic nervous system. It is further divided into parasympathetic nervous system and sympathetic nervous system. Normally what happens, the parasympathetic nervous system has an upper hand as compared to the sympathetic nervous system. So when we come across stress, what happens? The stress induces an autonomic imbalance. And there is decreased parasympathetic and increased sympathetic activity. And underactivity of GABA system, which is primary inhibitor neurotransmitter, that leads to allostatic mood. Yoga corrects this underactivity of parasympathetic nervous system through the stimulation of vagus nerve with the reduction in allostatic loop. As we can see in the picture, the stress response is shown. Now, what happens if suddenly a spider comes in front of our face? What happens? There is an area in our brain known as hippocampus. It gets stimulated and it sends signals to the hypothalamus. Hypothalamus further releases corticotropin releasing factor, which acts on the pituitary gland. And pituitary gland, as shown in the figure, in turn releases ACTH, which is also called as adrenocorticotropic hormone. Adrenocorticotropic hormone acts on the adrenal gland. And finally, there is a release of hormone that is called a stress hormone. And these are glucocorticoids or corticosteroids. So finally, what happens? The hypothalamus pituitary adrenal axis gets stimulated. And this hormone affects or it leads to increase in respiration, increase in heart rate, energy mobilization. There is dysfunction, immune function, and decreased GI function, and it also affects the gonads. Now, moving to the postulated mechanism, by which the yoga reduces cardiovascular risk and diabetes mellitus. As we can see in the figure, there are two pathways. Through pathway one, yoga intervenes and there is decreased perceived stress, decreased activation and reactivity of sympathoadrenal system, and decreased activity of hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis. On the other hand, we can see yoga intervenes by pathway two. Here, what happens? There is vagal stimulation or parasympathetic activation. It leads to increase in heart variability, baroreflex sensitivity, decrease inflammatory cytokines, decrease heart rate and blood pressure. Now, both these pathways lead to enhanced metabolic and psychological profile that includes increased insulin sensitivity, increased glucose tolerance, improved lipid profile, visceral adiposity is decreased, and improved mood and sleep. All these ultimately lead to improved coagulation, signalitic profile, decreased oxidative stress, and increased endothelial function. Now, ultimately, it reduces the risk for atherosclerosis, hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, as well as diabetes. Now, I will walk you through the benefits of yoga, and now beginning with the physiological benefits. There is improved general health, posture, muscle tone, sleep, immunity, and the pain tolerance. Yoga also helps us in normalizing weight. It stabilizes the autonomic nervous system. Yoga increases cardiorespiratory efficiency, musculoskeletal flexibility, range of joint movements, physical endurance, strength, and energy levels. It also helps us in decreasing heart rate, blood pressure, respiratory rate, left and electromyographic activity. Yoga also normalizes GIT and endocrine function. It also helps us in improving the psychological and cognitive benefits. So it improves mood, increases somatic awareness, kinesthetic awareness, subjective well-being, and feeling of self-acceptance and social adjustment. On the other hand, it decreases hostility, anxiety, and depression, and also helps us in improving attention, learning efficiency, depth perception, concentration, and memory. The biochemical effects of the yoga are, it helps us in improving biochemical profile, indicating an anti-stress and antioxidant effect. It's important in prevention of degenerative disorders. Now, as you all know, every study has its limitations, and so is yoga. It's not a miracle cure for all the problems, and especially not for emergency. We must consult a doctor whenever we are in doubt. And we all know that each patient is different, and so different approaches are there for different conditions. The key takeaway messages are, the ancient art and the science of yoga has infinite possibilities of solutions for the health-related issues faced by the modern humankind. However, we want it to be a miracle pill that we take only one and immediate solution to all the problems. But yoga is a holistic science, and it must be learned and practiced with a holistic view. The dedicated practice of yoga as a way of life is no doubt a panacea for psychosomatic stress-related disorders, helping us to regain our birthright of natural health and universal happiness. It has aptly been stated that no appreciable side effects and multiple collateral benefits, yoga is generally safe, simple to learn, and can be practiced by even ill, elderly, or disabled individuals. It has also been recommended as a beneficial adjuvant for the patient, as it is safe, simple, and economical therapy. So, the integration of yoga and modern medicine can help create a healthier and happier world. Thank you so much for your patience listening.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for valuable sessions and valuable talk. Thank you so much. And thank you to Dr. Nagar also, Dr. Savita Nagar ma'am. आपका भी बहुत आपने बहुत valuable time दिया.